the artists are always the first people to react when there is tension in society.
The best political art is not the art that hits you over the head. It's very subtle and it's very real. Art can really change opinions, I think, and it's a gradual process.
I think it's a little too early to tell with what the art world's response will be to Trump and Brexit. And I don't think it's necessarily one response either.
Art is always a reflection of our times, and political art has been with us forever. Of course, right now we can see a resurgence that is much stronger and much more evident, but it's not something new.
In 1983, the city was violent. People who were on drugs, crack was a big epidemic. Reagan was president. We were very politicized in those days. The art world itself was an extremely conservative time, showing a lot of male painters, but there was a lot of interesting politics. I think I see people now and young artists now looking back for a reference point. And I think you're seeing generations getting together, at least in New York and in other major cities.
We are kind of participant observers as artists, and we're just trying to make sense of things like anyone else.
People have always believed they lived in end times, and it's always been something we've predicted.
It's interesting to think about how the work kind of resonates in our current kinds of context. Makes you wonder why these sorts of themes become more mainstream again today. What kind of change is happening right now?
We hope we can allow people to see the world in a different way. And, you know, maybe you can see the booth as kind of us showing a hopefulness.
I think that artists now, if you look carefully, you can see seeds of what could happen down the road, for better or worse. But the art will predict the future.